All right, I think we can get started here. Just giving dogs some attention. But welcome everybody. Twitchy Tuesdays here on DDO stream with Sumorgu. That's me. Looks like my audio level's good. Stream looks good from local view. So, hello. Since you last saw me last week, I remember what level I was. Probably 16-ish. I've gained a few levels. That XP bonus over the weekend and a couple extra hours of playing this week got me up to 22. Especially last night, I got into a Epic Leap Bravery bonus group doing Lords of Dust and then the first Evening Star Chain, and that really was a nice XP boost. So yeah, that's all good stuff. Where was I going? Yeah. So I'm going to go start the Sentinels chain, I think. Don't think I have the quests, though, so I'll have to do that first. Can't remember if I picked it up or not. But that's the plan, at least for start with. Let's see how it goes. It may or may not work out. I don't know. So far, Epic Elites have been hit and miss. I've been able to do okay on some of them. Well, actually, Elites in general, here at the top end of Heroic in the first part of. Why am I not on that? I thought I took it. Blah. Hey, City, how's it going? Hope you're doing well this evening. Oops. My hand's in the right keys. Okay, now we're on Organ Blood. Is across the other side, I believe. Why? Again, wrong keys, finger combinations. It's not flashing, telling me where to go. I know it's over here. I forget which exact thing it is. It might be this one. Let's find out. Yay, Serenites. See, I've been having a interesting time trying to figure out what I can and can't do. Oh, let's do this. 19 to 20. Okay, 22. We'll just put that. Either people will understand what I'm doing or not. Either way, I don't mind. Try doing. Was it terminal? Oh, where's my celestial spirit? That's what I'm missing. There we go. I was trying to do terminal delirium, I think, last night, and we failed a couple times in that mirror room, and then just called it. Just a pug. And someone looked like they rage quit. Most other people just said, "Yeah, it's not working for us. Let's just not do that." So. Not a big deal. I was going to try to solo it. And that didn't go well either. Just that mirror room. Hey, Shu, how's it going? So let's see what happens. I anticipate this being difficult. We shall see exactly how difficult that is. Yeah, I may as well. That stuff.
Shut before you can slip inside.
So far, so good. Nope. Now we got multiples. Let's see how well this goes. So far tough but manageable. It's gonna go downhill quickly, I'm sure. Reminds me, I have not updated my page with my new hardware. Yeah, this doesn't look like it's going to do very well. It is amazingly awesome. I love it. I did get it on a heck of a sale. So it's a 34 inch 21 by 9 monitor I got for like $400. And it is tay awesome. It is ridiculously fun to have this much screen real estate to play with. Oh, it's a champion. Here we go. The thing I hate about Dark Delirium is that it just doesn't last very long as soon as you hit him. But yeah, Board Boat. Hello and welcome. I can highly recommend it. I'm actually going to get a second one, probably, so I can watch chat and such. I'll mail it over the other one. That's the current plan. And talking to the SO the other day when we were at the store. Yep. I've got a 27 handspree, I think. Also, and an old Dell 27. Those are my work monitors. I have to tell you, that Dell, I know Dell has gone downhill lately, but that monitor is like 15 years old, something like that. It's ridiculously old, and it still works great. It doesn't have the newer connections. Stand for it doesn't work very well anymore. It's not adjustable, but yeah, it's awesome. Still a good picture. Excuse me, all that stuff. Of course, it cost me a lot of money when I got it. But as far as longevity, it's probably the longest monitor I had for the longest. I used to have an old boat anchor kind of thing. Oh wow, that's gonna take a while. Yep. Really enjoyed that Dell. Techno Cat, welcome. Hello.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of easy to be paralyzed by choice. If I get another one of these for the same deal, I'm gonna get it. But otherwise, I'm not sure. I was looking at two just cheap, like Acers or something. And the SO recommended that I just go ahead and get another ultra wide. So, with that approval, I'm gonna look at that route instead. Just a second, I will pop out into one of my browsers. So many tabs open. And find my. Yeah, that should be it. If you're interested in what I'm using the game on right now, that should have it all. So now the question is to kite or not to kite? First mate. Oh, did I? Not even over there where I can do that yet. Have from behind. I can go back this way and open this one. There's a couple guys already ready for me. Hopefully, being archers, they won't be too bad. Let's see. Doesn't help if you miss your. Ah! Doesn't help if you have the wrong weapon on either. Here, let's. Plink you for one, or we could use the ESOS to actually do some damage. Need to get some more light and alignment spell power on here. I just haven't really done much in the way of gear. I did a little bit once I got epic, haven't figured out what else I want. Throw on here to finish off the holes. I might end up going ranged here. Just got a whole bunch of guys that I need to take care of. Let's see if we can just kite him out. Hello. Attention. I'm also paralyzed by, that decision making when I'm getting a minor price order together for some network cables and some various other things, and it's like, oh, there's so many choices, so many different things I want to get. Put together that order and going. Good day, Alfred. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you're doing well today. Let's see what we've got. I wonder if I can reach him. That does seem like a pretty good day. Had the timing there on there for a minute. Using Jotmon's porcupine build mostly from the forums. I changed a couple things around to suit my playstyle a little and my gear and stuff a little better. That's basically that build. Died already, thank you. See, that really shouldn't take an entire bunch of hit points to do that. I need more damage.
Frightened shoppers scatter as a group of murderous pirates attack.
I guess, well, I'm gonna go up the ladder here. First, let's see, we've got this is the build I'm using.
didn't quite get that right. There we go. I have got sewn skin on my whatchamajigger, green steel great axe, if I remember to use it. I do not have stone skin as a spell, though. There everybody is. I was wondering where they were. Hey, City, welcome back. In theory, I'm taking a lot less damage this way, but it takes a lot longer to do stuff. I had something to switch to while I'm doing this. That'd be good. Hello, give me my hit points, thank you. My old stand by the Sun Soul 6. I got some extra constitution from that. But I really need to make sure I get my spell power and stuff up. I suppose I could just craft something and that would do enough just to get it going. Alright. Anything I need to hit over here? There. Alright. No, I wanted to be up here, thank you. Try to get out of the way of that guy and still hit that one. There we go. So what's the XP on this? No, this is not great XP for the time it's going to take, but oh well. Ah, get off the ladder. If I had some sonic spell power and some light alignment spell power, I'd be doing a little bit better. For the most part, I'm doing okay. We'll see how the bosses go. That'll be interesting. Do I have auto attack on or something? Because seriously, stop attacking. I want to... One thing I really dislike about this is that... For some reason... It gets stuck in attack mode, and it's a pain to get out of it. Mostly I melee, but I know I'm gonna get hit a lot more. I'll save that for bosses, maybe. Because I do have limited resources. They're vast, but limited. Did everybody see Strim Tom's debut last night on the channel? That was fun. Alright, here we go again. Seriously, can we not do that? Now when I want it to auto-attack, it doesn't. I don't know why that happens like that.
Yeah, I didn't realize it's he was already starting, and I just had the channel open in another window. All of a sudden, it started. I'm like, wait a minute, that sounds like somebody I've watched before. Oh, look, it is. So yeah, ended up watching most of it, or at least listening to most of it. That's while I was playing in that group last night, so had to concentrate here and there. Wasn't able to follow the entire thing. You wanna come and show me you mean it, dude? Come on. Ever since I took my healing amp off, it's been a bit rougher. I switched tokens to my, or tokens, trinkets, to my epic spyglass, and I'm missing that repair amplification from the starter stuff. Lock. Oops. That's somebody else firing at me. This is supposed to be one of the easiest epic elites to solo, and I don't think I've soloed it on E yet. There's the first mate, how about that? Both of them actually went off. Interesting. I don't know why it gets stuck where you can't hit stuff sometimes. Other stuff besides your blast. First one fell down. Stop being blocked. Well, that's pretty convenient that he's trying to attack through that crate. If I could hit him. There we go. Uh-oh. He got out. I'd be worried if I was actually standing in there. He's gonna be a jerk, isn't he? Dude, I do not want to come down to your level. It's kiting time. Got him. This other one shouldn't be as bad as him. Did I hit my? Oh, I hit my 10,000 HP thing already. I'm gonna have to. That's my panic button. I need to get that back. Okay, is that all of them? Is there anybody else I need to kill from the top of the tower where they can't actually hit me? I don't think I'm gonna do the optionals. Not some XP, but I know maybe kind of tough here and there. See you, Quarterman. Jerks out of my range. Get in range, you jerks. Hello, up the ladder. Up the ladder, please. Thank you. I want a UI overhaul so bad in this game. There are so many things I want better. Still very impressive that it supports ultra wide screens just fine. Yeah, stuck firing. Hello. I'm not firing anymore. Thank you. Is to escape for the win. Hello, everybody. How are you? Somebody got stuck finally. The Iron Hands. Hello. This could be a bad idea because of that sorcerer, but let's see. Seriously, stop. Thank you. That's so annoying. Hope you're doing well this evening, Iron Hands. Spent half the workday in a training class about giving good service to customers, basically. I love that out of range message. I'm trying to do something right in front of my face. Out of range. Why is that? The other issue with the UI overhaul is that it's not sexy, it doesn't bring in revenue or more customers, so yeah. It's the kind of thing that generally gets put low on the priority list because of that. First. Come on. Off for a moment. No, turn it off. Turn it off. Jeez. Ugh. No. Titan, you're gonna kill my bravery bonus. Hello. First mate. Hello, changing shapes. It's not even let me change shapes. It's really annoying. Oops. That's not good. Actually, maybe it is. If I bring them closer, they might hit the platform more than me. He's not chaining like he's supposed to. Alright. Go back to this thing. That guy's throwing stuff from way back there. Way back there. This end fight's going to be really interesting. Mr. Jerkface, how are you, Mr. Jerkface? So I'm doing what? 150-200 per? It's definitely less than I'm doing with melee. But I'm also taking a lot less damage, so. There's that aspect of it. Go back to chain. Those other guys were going to run over here and get hit as well. That's why I switched to chain, but it doesn't seem to be happening. These guys are over twice my level. Let's go back to this. All right. Oh, hey, a champion archer. How about that? There's another guy down here. I did get just him, yay. All right. Yep, I got off the auction house. I don't remember ever seeing those up for sale in the store, so I must not have been playing around the time that happened. I spent a lot of plat on it though, like 2 million or something, I don't remember. I like it. Alright, back to chain, let's see what we can do here. I get asked about it quite a lot, so they're still pretty rare. Be nice if this melee guy would back up or the archer would come a little closer. Yeah, I've lost track of how many million I've made. Got rid of a lot of it. Buying stuff here and there. I don't know if anyone expected to sell the stuff that I bought, but they did. Think. I don't know if I bought plus four, plus five tomes with plat or something significant. Now, I never remember if this is the slave pen or the end. I often get confused and do the other one, the one I don't want to do. I wouldn't mind getting these for every character, but at least the ones I stream with. Definitely helps pick you out of the crowd. Unless everybody else also has them, and it doesn't do much for you. Dude is patiently waiting there trying to kill me. Minute, dude, your turn will come. This is where the whole party comes in handy. And spread the damage around and actually get stuff done. I feel like this is just taking forever. So I think this is the right spot, but I'm not sure. I'll call those guys that chased me and then lost sight of me. Nobody's gonna stay. Well, a couple extra seconds of damage, I'll take it. What? I'm casting Reconstruct on myself. Who cares if I'm not facing a pirate? Ah! Feels the worst time sometimes. There's two down. Ooh, Skrilla just took a. Alright, there we go. So now I can't get past that because I haven't done something else. What haven't I done? Have I done that? I've done that. That's the other one for that. Is there a, oh, I haven't done the one up here. That's what it is. Oh, hello. That's where the traps come in. I forgot about that being that portion of the thing. Yeah, I never really understood why people were saying that they had too much plat until I kept running a bunch of epics and like, oh yeah, if you keep running epics, you do end up with a whole lot of plat. Okay, for only one visible trap, that was a lot of damage. It was a little annoying. Let's see if I can chain some DIs down here. Oh, great. Now I'm aggroing all these guys. That's cool. This might be a death. It's probably going to be a death, I should say. Not might. Oh, yeah, that doesn't work on reconstruct. Awesome. Get up the ladder! Get to the chopper. Probably gonna die before any of this matters, but just in case, let's. Oh, I have lay on hands. I completely forgot I had lay on hands. Huh. So, yeah, let's let these guys kind of de-aggro. Oh, that was odd. Must be slightly on the edge of something. Let's go ahead and use land hands a couple times. There we go. I haven't really used land hands that much. It's been speed direct construction and shining through. Kind of forgot I had it. Alright, speaking of shining through, let's get that started. So let's do spirit back on. Wonder if I can invis the way over there. Not on alert. Oh, please use that on me. I'm immune to magic missiles. Keep using them. After everything you're doing, that's the thing that is the best for me. That's it, just keep using them. Where did that Bane damage come from? Interesting.
A strange shape charges towards you. Could this be the general manager?
Is he going or not? It'd really be nice if you could hide him into the traps. Back in the traps. I didn't think he was gonna get out of that door. I don't care who I'm hitting as long as I'm hitting somebody. Again, I'm using a burst. What does it matter if I'm not facing him?
Grr.
That really should not happen. I guess it cut him into the walls and then have him be stunned, that'd be cool. It's interesting, I'm floating above the ground, but being affected by the terrain still. See, it looks like I need to figure out some gear to really do this a lot better. Thank you. third of the hit points to con. Or third hit points left, I should say. And then phase two. I'm not too worried about completing, it's just it's taking a lot longer than I was hoping. Sarlonis, Enoch, hello. Welcome. I'm trying to keep up on chat while I'm surviving.
Not exactly easy.
But this is really demonstrating why DDO is not like other games, right? Because I'm mobile and it matters because I can dodge these spear attacks, take a lot less damage. And then get hit by one as soon as I say that. I can dodge his melee rush. Not take damage from that. And meanwhile, I'm pew pew pewing away. Of course, those crippling hits kind of hurt. Really reduced my mobility. Under 3,000 left. Under 2,000 left. He's a big bag of hit points anyway. Oh, he's still rushing. That's cool. Not really. Oh. Yay, there's one down. Now, jerk face to go. And he has 2/3 of the hit points the other guy did, so yeah. I wonder if he's better to melee. Let's see. Probably still take a lot less damage by dodging. Let's see what happens when I switch to melee. Nothing else, it's something different. He doesn't do that stupid kobold thing, jump over every obstruction, get somewhere where you can't normally get, he'll be fine. No, this doesn't seem too bad. Then if I do this, in theory, I'll be getting even better numbers. I did roll a natural 20 there. Saw that. Okay, city, see it. So I'm trying to do here, which is why I wanted to continue the bravery bonus streak, is get to 28 and do another iconic, do an iconic reincarnation, which I haven't done yet, before we get our lovely cap increase. I'd like to fit that in. At least one. Since that's coming up really soon, we'll see how it's gonna go. But I was getting 100k per quest yesterday, and that adds up pretty quick. What I should do is keep a potion on hand, and then if I get on one of those trains like that where they just blow through stuff with the bravery bonus, then use it there. And really make use of that time. I also would like to get it in a Vaughn 560. That would be awesome. But I don't think I'm flagged yet, so kind of have to do the first four. Sun's weakness on it is helping accelerate the process. Three Bane dice each hit. That helps. So 35k in almost an hour. That's not very efficient. I'd be better off doing dailies if I'm going to do that. Do I really care much about the chest to do this? Yeah, I guess. I got the XP anyway, so this doesn't matter if I get killed by elementals. Yeah, I'm trying to get behind that door. Perfect. Oh, if I get the other chest. Nope. I wanted a champion, that's cool. By cool, I mean terrifying. We'll just do that. So yeah. I kept my bravery bonus alive, but really wasn't worth it. Yeah, I mean, dailies do get boring, but they're also fairly efficient at grinding through the XP that I need. Considering I need, what, 500 and some? Okay, to do what I need to do. Yeah. Those wings just blew me right out of where I wanted to be. Darn dragons. Who put dragons in this game? Oh, wait a minute. Kind of expect it. I also noticed last night that the see, I'd love to run that even if it's EH because I've got bravery bonus. That would be awesome. No, yeah, all right, let's I think I'll take a quick break just because that was pretty intense. I didn't expect that to be quite as intense as it was. Trying to stay alive through all that, but walk around a little bit, repair my gear, and then we'll continue on with something or other. Hopefully there'll be a good LFM up we can run with. If not, then we'll figure it out. So we'll be back shortly. Thanks for watching. Do appreciate you hanging out, and I'm back in something like 5-10 minutes. All right. I think I'm ready to go again. No groups popped up. Yeah. A little later on, it should be better. I'm hoping. It was last night. It was a lot better. A little bit later in the evening, like 7:30. There was a bunch of stuff. Unfortunately, by the time I was already in that group, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, but kind of got stuck in it. It was good, though. Good to blow through some of those. Actually, I'm going to go to the bank real quick. Better than nothing. I'll have that as backup. I don't think I have anything else in here. It's gonna help. Just throw that up there as an option. Hey, Kadarius, yep. I gained, I don't know, I was like, was I 16 last week? Something like that. So I've been playing a bit, trying to get my levels up there so I can do an iconic reincarnation before the level cap gets increased. I'm finding I'm kind of at the edge of my abilities here in equipment. So I forgot to grab my Hirelings, didn't think. Or do I have them already? This whole having the TR cache is interesting. I really haven't figured out what I'm going to do next. This is kind of far, as far as I thought it out. I might just do pure Paladin. Blade Forged. I might try a ranged build. I don't know. There's so many options. So much stuff I haven't done yet. The 17 one, I don't want the 17 one. See you, Serranos, Enoch. Thanks for stopping by. Do appreciate that. Yeah, I recommend that Barbarian new player build, and then I haven't actually played one, but a Paladin, pure Paladin is also pretty good, at least in the saves department, which is helps me not frustrated when you're just starting out. I guess I do want the 17, don't I? There's so much stuff in this cache. This is one of the big UI points I would like to improve, along with the character sheet. Inventory management. Let's go ahead and take the 17. And I think that's all I need. Yeah, if you watch Gary's Musk one or Strimtom's one he was doing yesterday, they show some pretty insane damage with range. I have yet to build a cleric that I liked. Rogue is a horrible choice for new players. Do not do Rogue. It is way too gear dependent. Way too gear dependent. And you're not going to have that as a first life Rogue. So, in my opinion, that Rogue is a horrible choice. And then you have the problem where, and this is something I personally encountered when playing a Rogue for the first time, is people expect you to have all the trapping abilities, all the stats, all the boosts, all the ever gear, and know where all the trap boxes are and everything. It's a horrible choice for first life. There's just too many expectations for you to play it and enjoy it.
Don't think that's a good idea. All right, where should my hirelings go?
My bars are kind of random at the moment. After having the same bar layout for so long because I had not TR'd, it's weird to have like things in different places now because I don't remember exactly where they were. Plus, I have all these different abilities. I'm using different gear and all this stuff. It's just odd. Try to handle all that. All right. So that's because anything. Nope, still Orchard Slayers, which I do not want to do. Let me look up that build real quick. See. Yeah, here it is. I would say that one's an awesome choice. And then there's also that one. And this is a really fun build to play, although it is a monk. So, yeah. I think those are the only ones I have tagged there. The Pale Trapper, Challenge Farm for some, yeah. And then, of course, my Morning Lock. And then, let's see, I've got a Swashbuckler, a Tempest Trap Monkey. Yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, so my choices now are what? There's another UI piece that needs to be redone so I can look at 20s on Epic and see what I can do. I can do. Yeah, I'm not
Gonna do that.
I'd like to do Vaughn 1 through 4. It definitely requires a party though. I mean, that's Black Lock and stuff is right there. Small problem, snitch. I don't want to do small problem solo though. Those are other options. House P. House P, House P, House P. I don't have the skills for everything. So, what level are those? I can wait because those are higher level. Okay, so let's say House P and see what happens in. Which would be better, snitch or probably snitch. See what happens with snitch.
The sounds and smells of the busy tavern drift in from the next room. Perhaps Roderick now will
I'm
cause
gonna
a
go
sign
ahead
if you
and
ask
summon
him
these
to try and
guys.
speak.
questions in a public. Just for distraction, if nothing else. And of course, the bars are on top of each other. All right. I forgot to shining through it. There we go. Got this here at least. It's a good start. My Albar's stuck in the other room, isn't he? I mean, granted, the Albert would probably have gotten killed, but at least try to get here. The stench of smoke walks back the corridor. You guys need to stay here. Why is my Onyx Panther almost dead when I told him to stay there and not move? I guess because he's an idiot is the best answer to that. I'd rather not take that damage. This is why I figured this would be the best one to do, because it's very possible to avoid much of the fighting. I guess I could select the Panther. Let's see what Land Hands does. There we go. He's got some hit points now. Oops. Alright. Let's keep them there.
If you could lower one of the nearby ladders, you would be able to climb
if only
to the rooftops.
As you turn about, I probably should have saved that Misty Escape for way back. Yeah. This is not gonna go well. Oh, hey, Mocha's on.
Okay.
And might die. Let's see here. I don't care who I get. Just somebody. You know what? I forgot I didn't have priority. Should be getting better damage now. We can't do this until after Kratos, can we? Did I ever tell you the story of the time that somebody rage quit the group because I destroyed this box? That's the story. I'm done. I thought it was pretty silly. Personally, here we go. To deal with Kratos. Yeah, I probably should go back to melee. Because they wanted to use that box to get up on the ledge and avoid the flame traps that are there. But I just thought it was a bit too much to rage quit over. I mean, I know everybody has their own viewpoints and does things differently, but yeah. It just seemed like a bit much. I understand you get frustrated with something, but if somebody smashes a box, big deal. Jump around it, or there's other ways to get through that rather than just using that particular box. But yeah. I don't know. It wasn't on this server, it's on a different server. I don't know which server it was on. No, two deaths down. Of course, they're on their stones. Because that's not annoying at all. Boop, 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 doop. Yeah, I know. It's like, yeah, okay, be frustrated, but. Whatever. Different people, different priorities. Now, can you guys figure out the rest shrine as well? Let's get some free healing out of it. Are we getting some trap bonuses? That's cool. Bonuses. Let's see, is this gonna work? Yes, it is. Cool. We already got more XP just for that. This could work if we stick with this party. We've got trapping and stuff, then this could actually work. I don't understand that at all. That's all. There we go. My owlbear's stuck. That's awesome. Way to contribute to the party, dude. Just for fun. I think I forgot to get some breakables, but oh well. Figure it out.
Your pursuit has led you out of Tanner's alley and into a quieter, more prosperous neighborhood.
Yeah, I just realized I have Cocoon and I don't even have it mapped anywhere. Sunshine below. That's hilarious.
You can catch up to Roderick Nettle and still let sleeping dogs lie. A magical field flickers into place, protecting the upper courtyard.
If somebody else is going that way, I'm going to go this way. I don't know how many times I've opened this.
and people still go down the other way. And it's so frustrating. It's like, I opened the shortcut. Why don't you just take the shortcut? You know? So much easier.
Second, let me dismiss
Alok. 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 If I could spell. No, they're not on. Okay. We're all good there. Hey Gary, how's it going?
Been pretty well this evening.
Oh, saw you did a stream earlier today. Of course, I was at work, so I couldn't do too much. But I did pop in for a little bit.
Nettle's familiar giggle can be heard in the next courtyard. It's time to deal with him once and for all.
Alright, let's get this done.
I suppose I should stone skin. Or was I already stone skinned? Oh well. And I should remember to displace. Which is another thing I always forget to do. Always? Yeah, pretty much always. Definitely big. loot. No love, no love, no love, no love. That's too bad. See, I just got that. Crimson plus 8 is tempting. But we'll go with what we got. Yeah, there's starting to be more LFMs up now. I'd like to do. Oh, let's. Or, you know, maybe not. Whatever. Still gonna try it. Go ahead and put Luminous Truth on, and then we'll do Eldritch Blast.
The air, with the Mark's enchantment, the illusions around you dissipate. The way deeper into the Illusionarium is open. The air suddenly shifts from tropical heat to bitter cold. It is as if you were teleported leagues away. Walk a few feet.
Holy cow, that's bright. Need my sunglasses. Whew. That ice.
These arches
and the fun reindeer wolves.
Are they simply decorative? With House Fialin, one can't tell.
That makes things easier.
Though you can see the rest of Stormreach through the skylights above, the light from outside does not reach this room. The only illumination comes from phosphorescent mushrooms. Of shadow created copies of itself. They must be illusions. Only destroying the
room
will end this death trap. That must be the illusionary ones have disappeared. Unlike the previous room, this place feels like it's baked in.
Thank you. take care of this illusionary guide first. And then we'll concentrate on the scorpion. I love seeing all that purple damage. It's awesome.
The destruction of this make-believe scorpion has also extinguished the mark of shadow. The illusionary barrier is gone.
That's good, City. It's always nice to help new players and get up there. Awesome, City. Unfortunately, most people who finish the game just don't love it as much as I do. No, it's okay. No big deal. I don't think it's required or anything. It's appreciated, but not required. Yeah.
It's nice to get back.
Be nice if Misty Escape recharged faster. Okay, those are down. Why did I get damaged by a stump? Doesn't seem to make any sense. There's a daily group going. I may have to switch you over to daily group at some point.
House Vialin's illusionarium, but you still need to enter the chapter house and stop the Maleficent Cabal's attack.
Good. I think it's a tie between the combat and character customization. Because both things are excellent. House must have been closed as a precaution during the Grand Gala. Next to the security gates, a large dragon mark of shadow is embedded into the wall. If it were to activate, you would not be able to destroy it as you did with the marks in the Illusionarium. Because I really enjoy the character flexibility, different things you can do, depending on exactly how you build the character and what gear you equip and all that. Not that I've used much, but it's okay to top off.
Oh no! The Sawagin found
me! Thank you for the follow, Technocat. Appreciate that.
The illusions in this display hall don't appear to be interactive like the ones in the Illusionarium. They probably won't attack you. Hopefully. You finally reached the House Fiarlan Grand Gala. Now, to find the guest list and add Cyan's name.
I have no social skills. Ha ha ha. Bailey's looking for the poisoner first.
One of the drink servers looks like an elf, but you see through her disguise to the glowing red eyes of her true tiefling form. No one is using the library at the moment. House Fialan elves must appreciate their parties more than a good book.
The end's gonna be if we can get the we should be able to get all the options, I hope.
Lucy's face was much cleaner than the one she had planned for her victims. Cyan should be able to find an antidote for any poison the party guests have already imbibed.
It's the fun one. I usually do this one first, then find the tiefling, but, you know. spellmaster's death, anyone under nice. His mental control has been set free. Here comes the fun part.
You see the aura of a powerful illusion around this guard. He's not an elf at all. His glowing eyes betray his tiefling heritage.
See you, city. Yep, TR is a good point too, Gary. Poised to strike at the ball. That goes back to the many ways you customize and do your character, because your past lives add into that too. Some builds really don't even work well without past lives. But also, you know, each time you reincarnate, you can be a different build. So that's keeps it interesting, rather than just the guard is still waiting at the restroom, reincarnating over and over again using the same build and all that, which would be kind of boring in comparison to what you should do. Thank you.
How the heck did that get through the wall? Oh, it didn't. There's another spellcaster in here. Okay. Noticed that before. Anybody else? I may get tired of the ease sooner than I expected, because it's just a bunch of hit points to get through. I'm the only left having it. But there were some of these. I love seeing all that purple damage, it's so awesome. Purple, 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 scroll, scroll, scroll. So much purple. Shrine out there, we don't need that. That's right. Trigger Scion and then Shrine, probably. Oh, that's right, we don't need to worry about it because we did everything. Huh. Just realized that's why we're not worrying about shrining. But we've got time for Cyan to walk, so it doesn't really matter. Just have a habit of resting when I have a chance like that. So if I do the dailies every day, twice a day, maybe get a Vaughn 1 through 6 EE group going at some point. Might be able to beat the deadline. Maybe not. We'll see. Now we get to watch the nice little drama play out. Hey, where's his manservant going? Hey, who's that? Let's see, that's a better place to watch everything from. Bwahaha. Bwahaha.
Yeah, I never have really studied this dude's face while he's doing this.
Flushed. Ha ha ha, flushed.
Dejected tiefling. He's drinking his dagger. Woot. 70k, 25 minutes. That actually wasn't horrible, considering some of the others. Ooh, a mask of tragedy. Ooh, a mirror cloak.
All right, well, that was good.
I would like to do more, but I really don't think I have the concentration to do. Keep going on E at this level right now. So, I believe I can fly. No. I think I'm going to call it for the night. I might get back on later off stream and play just a little bit more, but EE is just so much more difficult. I don't feel like I can play as much when I do EE. Have a lot more concentration and attention needed. Otherwise, you know, other stuff I can be just sort of casual running through and not really worry about stuff. So I enjoyed it. Hey Rothko, how's it going? Thanks for watching. And I appreciate everybody watching. Catch all the other fun stuff on this channel. My information's on screen if you want to see more of me in particular. We have lots of nice broadcasters on this channel that are doing stuff pretty often. We're filling up the week here. So there's also openings in the schedule if you feel like you want to stream on here. Let Cordovan know and we can hook you up. Yes, that was the porcupine build. Is that Tirith? Yeah, that was porcupine build. I linked it earlier. I can't find it at the moment, but yes. And see you next week, if not before. Thanks for watching, and yeah, good night, everybody.